If you look at this, and I ask you, what is it? You might say, that's a pear. But in fact, it's not a pear, it's a piece of china. This is a real pear. And when you put them side by side, it's very easy to say which one is which. But most of the time, we don't get the luxury of that. We see one object, and we have to decide what it is. I'm Professor Jane Raymond at the University of Birmingham in the Department of Psychology. And my area of research is understanding how we categorize objects into different groups, when we see something as real or when we see something as not quite real. How do we make those decisions? There's a lot of brain processes that go into that. We use different sensory cues to decide if something is the real thing or not quite the real thing. And we're interested in understanding how quickly people can do this and also what kinds of information they use. Understanding how we authenticate something is quite important in the modern digital world because there's so much fake information, fake news, fake objects, counterfeit brands, and even counterfeit money. Because it's so easy to duplicate brand packaging and visual information, counterfeit of all sorts of things is becoming an increasing problem. In fact, counterfeit goods costs worldwide something like $64 billion a year. And it has a huge effect on the economies around the world. This is due to lost revenue, lost taxes, and even lost jobs. So here in my lab, we're working on the understanding of the basics of how the brain codes when something is real and when it's not real. We do a lot of work with banknotes because those are interesting. It's an interesting problem. And we try to help central banks around the world understand what makes a counterfeit easy to see or makes a genuine note easy to tell when it's real or not real. So a great deal of advance in material science that makes what they call security features, special printed areas on a note, particularly difficult to counterfeit. And they provide visual signals or tactile signals sometimes to the general public that they can use to say, ah, this is real or this is not real. So we're helping the banks to understand how they can use that kind of information, where they can put it on a note, which one is better than another, and how people can do these authentications so quickly, what kind of brain signatures are involved, and what kind of brain processes. So that's how we take basic research in the lab on how we recognize objects, like how we decide, is this a pair or not a pair? And we apply it to the real world to solve real world contemporary problems. Thanks very much.